Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to make foil quill designs for your Cricut in Adobe Illustrator. All right, let's get started. All right, so I'm in Adobe Illustrator, and I'm just going to create a new file. I'll come over here to Create New, and then I'll come up here to Print at the top. I'll choose Letter, and then Create. Now for my foil quill design, I want it to consist mostly of text. So I'm just going to type out the text that I want to use. I'll hit T on my keyboard, which will bring me to the text tool. And I'll just click once. I'll type, I want that on one text line. And then I'm just going to option and click and drag this. And then I'll type beautiful. I want that on its own text line also. So I'll get back on my selection tool and I'll option drag this. And then I'll get back on my text tool, click in there and select all with Command A or Control A on a PC. And then I'll type life. So I've got three different text lines that say it's a beautiful life. I'm gonna select all of those with my selection tool and I'll get right on the corner and then I'll hold shift and drag to make it a lot bigger. Okay, now I want this and this to be the Montserrat font. So I'll just type that up here in character, and then I'm just going to choose Montserrat thin. And I actually want both of these to be uppercase, so I'm going to go to type, change case, and uppercase. And then for beautiful, I want to use the font Dark Star. That looks good. And then I will grab a corner and hold shift and make it a lot bigger. Okay, maybe we'll make this a little bit smaller by holding shift and resizing. And I want life also pretty big. I'm just going to select everything and make it a little smaller so we can keep it on the artboard at least. I'll hit Z and that'll bring me to my zoom tool. I'll draw a box around it all, which will help me to zoom in. And I'm just going to bring this right up here, make it a little bit smaller. Okay, now first off, these two aren't connected, so I'm going to hit T to get in between those two letters. And I'm going to option and left arrow and bring that in. That just adjusts the kerning. And I'll use my arrows to bring this over and in a little bit. When you're creating foil quill designs, you can only have a single line. And fonts actually are made up of shapes instead of lines. So this looks like lines, but it actually is a closed shape if we outline it. So let's go ahead and select all with Command A or Control A and outline. We can do that by hitting Shift Command O or Shift Control O on a PC. You can also go up here to type and create outlines, it's right here. Okay, so now you can see a little better that these are not single lines, they're actually rectangles and shapes. So we need each one of these to be a single line, and to do that, I'm going to use my A tool. A is the direct selection tool. I'm going to click on the pieces that I want, which is just the right side of this line. Probably will help if we go into Command Y or Control Y mode. So I'm only selecting this line. I'm going to select the top and then also the right side here. I'm holding Shift to select all of these. Then I'm going to cut these with Command X or Control X on a PC. I'll delete this. And then I'll paste in front with Command F or Control F. So you can see we've only got the single line, the one that we selected. And these two are not centered anymore because I had to take the right side of that line. So let's center those up. Oops. So I'm going to make sure I'm aligned to selection and I'll center these. And I'm going to take this point with my A tool or direct selection and just use my arrows to move it up to that other line. If it moves too far, you can change your preference. So I'm going to go into Command K or Control K and change this to 0.2. Now when I move, it doesn't go as far. Okay, with this, I just want to delete this line and this point. So now I have a single line apostrophe. With this, I'm going to delete this point. I want to keep this one on the inside. and that becomes the outside. So I'm going to delete this point, and then I'll select just that inner area and delete it. So that leaves me with just the one line, and we can do the same here. I'm going to keep the inner triangle, and then I'll also keep these two lines here. I'll select this line with the direct selection, hold shift, and select the other one. I'm going to Command X to cut them, delete what's left, and then paste in front. And that'll leave the parts of the A that I want. Okay, so we've got a single line for these letters now. Now with this, it's going to be much harder to do that. I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. And I'm going to lock this. I'll hit Command 2 on my keyboard. Or you can also go to Object, Lock Selection. And now we can draw right on top of this without, you know, interacting with it. While we're at it, let's highlight these. We want to just have an outline. So I'm going to switch the fill to an outline by hitting this arrow. Okay, so with this part, I'm going to use the pen tool and just trace around these areas, just using the font as a template. So I'll zoom in here and hit P on my keyboard. I'm going to click here and just click and drag. Click and drag here. And I think I'll change my color to something you can see a little better. Maybe increase the size of it. Now I'll get back on my pen tool and click on the last one I clicked on. And I'll just come down here like this. Now I'll start a new line up here. Okay, and I'm just going to go ahead and trace the rest of this. I'll speed it up so you don't have to sit through it. For the eye, I'm just going to draw a circle. I like to go into outline mode so I can kind of see things a little differently. Sometimes it helps, and sometimes it makes it a little more confusing. Going to pull this one a little closer to this so it'll seem continuous, even though it's not. Okay, this is looking pretty good. And now I'm going to do the same thing with life. Instead of redrawing, I'm going to do what we did up here on It's A and just use pieces of what's already there. So I'm going to select this little corner. I'll select this side of the F and this side of the F. I also want this piece and this piece. And I want this piece. This piece, that one, and then this. And I'm going to Command X. That'll cut them. I'll delete what's left and then I'll paste in front with Command F. And then I'll hit D on my keyboard and that gives me a white fill and a black outline. I don't need the white fill, so I'll just get rid of that. And now we can just move the pieces over and up that don't connect. All right, I'm going to unlock the black. So I'll come up here to Object, Unlock All, and I'll just delete it. Now I'll select everything and I'll get back on my stroke and just click on the green. It'll make everything the same width. Okay, now this is a little rough right up here. So I'm going to hit N and get my pencil tool and just smooth it out holding Option or Alt on a PC. And anywhere where it's not looking very good, we can just adjust it to look a lot nicer. Right here, it looks kind of weird. I'm going to Command Y, zoom in, and then grab this point and just move it along this line. It doesn't actually have to attach to it, but you want to just have it lining up pretty well. Okay, so I think we're ready to save as an SVG file. So I'm going to go to File, Save As. We'll change this to SVG. And we'll use artboards. I usually save my SVG as basic 1.1 because it's a really old file and almost any system can open it. So we'll say okay. Now when we come out here to Cricut Design Space, we can upload it. And here it is. I'll save it and insert it. Some of the green came through. That's where a closed shape is. So if we come up here to line type and choose cut, we can change this to draw. And now those are gone. And that's all you need to do to create a foil quill design. And now you can foil it with your machine. All right, if you like this video, just click on the like button and I'll see you next week with another SVG cut file tutorial. Thank you.